Armaramka. Armaramka is come from reindeer people because there are so many. My mother came from that Armaramka tribe. The name of this is Sanishtak the Min Fancy Parka. And it never uses for hunting or anything. It just wear it in ceremonial or a dress up. We have a good clothing when dress up time. It seems to me like we just own everything from the ancient times from our ancestors. We have a beautiful clothing. I don't know who made this. With a very good singers, even this is a men's pattern. Women have a different pattern, men have a different pattern. We have a dyed unborn seal fur, and they put them about this long, and dangly things on the wind. Everything is different between male and female, the clothing. I think this is a Uguk. Makluk, we call it, bearded seal intestine. And it took a lot of work to do that, and when it just, we just clean the inside out, pour some water in, and take it out so many times, and then we use our fingernail, thumb fingernail, to take the outer part off. And that when it's done, we turn the inside out, and then we rang them, and the water turns red, and we change it so many times. I told you, my grandma is too much for me, but I'm going. And until the water turns clear, and then she took them out in winter time and blow it off, and when they freeze, she just using her arms, hold on like that and tie them up and tie it up on the meat rack. And it stays there for a long time. Wind and coldness had turned it white.
Crested auklet is a little bird about this big with a, like on the beak there's those orange colors and a quill up here like it has a ponytail. And that's a crested auklet bird. I'm Elaine. My Eskimo name, Siberian Yupik name is Ruktinga. It's a Chukchi name given to me by my relatives, reindeer herders. They were reindeer herders from Russia. My clan is Kiwami. And in Chukchi, I think my name is Ruktinga. And in our language, it's called Utakhtikak. In English, it means came back. And my last name is Kingeekuk. I'm from Sibunga, St. Lawrence Island, but I'm living in Anchorage now. The reason why I'm here is I'm here to repair gutskin parka. It's made out of walrus intestine with auklet curls. If it weren't repaired and left alone, it would keep on deteriorating, and probably that's the only one left. And people from home wouldn't see anything like that again, only from pictures or drawings. This gut material, you have to have years of experience. When you're doing it for the first time, it made me feel like I was trying to sew tissue paper. My stitch would be too big, too small, too crooked, or it would rip right through. Normally, if it was a newer one, like newer, still used, I would put a piece of intestine on the inside and sew on to make a patch, like put the patch on the inside. What I'm going to do is, because this is an older material, I'm going to do one on the inside and one on the outside and try to camouflage that, and then I'll sew around the tear. And I decided to use sinew instead of commercial thread, because it would be, the material is almost like skin. My mother learned from my grandma. And I dedicate the repair work and the extra information I give to them and all the elders. I could hear my ancestors speaking to me, like the memories in my heart. Like I hear them talking to my students, yeah, I want to pass this on. It's best to pass this on.